In this tutorial, you will learn how to create residual plots in Excel 2016 in order to check assumptions for a linear test. You should have already created a scatter plot and a linear model for your data using the previous tutorials. Once we have a linear model for our data, we'd like to assess the assumptions of this model by checking the residual plot. To begin, I'm going to go ahead and copy my funny and happy data for my male participants into a new sheet. In order to create the residual plots, we will use the data analysis tool pack. If you do not already have this installed, please check out that tutorial handout. In order to do a linear model in Excel using the data analysis tool pack, you can have no missing values within your data. You can see here we have a missing value for funny and for happy. We'll begin by sorting our data. When you sort in Excel, it will automatically put the blank values at the bottom. So here you can see it's put our missing funny value at the bottom, so we can delete this value. We can sort again now, this time by happy. Scroll down and delete the missing value here as well. Now that our data is cleaned, we're ready to proceed. So we will go to Data, the Data Analysis Tool Pack, and we will select the regression option and then click OK. Our input Y range will be our Y variable. Here we were trying to predict happiness, so happy will be our Y value. So I will select the header and then all of the data below it. Normally I will just select a column entirely, but in the data analysis tool pack for the regression examples, you can only use the selected data. If you attempt to select the entire column, you will get an error message. I will repeat the same process for the X variable. So I will just select the header funny and then scroll down to the bottom of my data. I did include these headers funny and happy, so I will check the labels box. I will go ahead and put my output into this same sheet. So I will click somewhere beside my data. And I would like one plot, the residual plot, for my data. So I will check the residual plots box. And then I will click OK. You can see here in this output, we get a significant amount of information. We get the coefficients, which will be the same ones that were found in our equation in which we calculated the linear model from the scatter plot. You will also see p-values for these statistics. You will see the same R squared from our last video, and we'll get the R as well, or the correlation between our two variables as well. Inspecting the residual plot, we can check here for issues with our data. This is a way to exaggerate the issues that may have cropped up with your data, so you can check for violations of assumptions. It appears here from our data we have a fairly wide scatter of residuals around zero. There don't appear to be any consistent trends to our data, although it does appear that we may have an outlier here, as this point does not really hang with the rest of our points. So it may be that for our value of 3 on funny, we have an outlier present. What you would like to see in a residual plot is no clear trend. This is our ideal residual plot, just a variation completely random of the residuals. We don't want to see any kind of clear trend because these give us evidence that we may be violating our assumptions. If we see some kind of curvature to our data, if these points make some kind of curve, then that is evidence that we may have non-linear data, that it may be that some type of exponential model may be more appropriate for our data. So here we see we have a wide amount of spread at the beginning, and then down here we have very little spread. So this indicates that we're violating homogeneity of variance assumption. Again, we want to see something much like this where we have no consistent trend in our data. Looking at our residual plot, there don't appear to be any consistent patterns, so it doesn't appear that we're violating the spread condition, and there's definitely no curvature to our data, so our linearity assumption seems to hold. Here we can see that it just appears that there's a random scatter of data. We may have an outlier here, and we might want to mention that in our write-up, but other than that, it seems that our assumptions are holding according to this residual plot.